Welcome back to Tempo Control. So many gaming news stories happened this week, but we don't have enough time to give them full coverage, so let's cover them in quick hits. Rumors popped up that Nintendo would be helping Ubisoft financially produce Beyond Good and Evil 2 as an NX exclusive, similar to the deal with Sega and Bayonetta 2. This would be great. I mean, Beyond Good and Evil, critical success, not a commercial success. And I love the test footage that I saw several years ago, kind of looked Uncharted-esque. Now, I don't know if that's the same at all, but this would be a really good move on Nintendo's part, if they did it, of course, since it's a rumor. It would just build a lot of goodwill with the players, and they kind of need that right now. No Man's Sky, finally coming out June 21st, 2016. Has a nice special edition on PlayStation 4 and even some editions beyond that, but it's good to see that this is finally coming out, though no mention of VR support. Maybe we'll see in a couple weeks what's happening with PlayStation VR. Is that going to be a thing? It seems perfect for No Man's Sky. Uncharted 4, A Thief's End has been delayed a couple weeks from April 26th to May 10th, 2016. Damn it. Maybe they shouldn't have stolen that art. I'm just kidding. Naughty Dog's gonna do great work, take as much time as they need. This game is gonna be great. Harmonix is attempting to crowdsource $1.5 million for a Rock Band 4 PC port. They're doing this through Fig, which is the same new platform that Psychonauts 2 got funded through, but really? Really, it almost seems like a parody, but it's real. This is the game industry right now? I mean, come on. Pre-orders went up for a development kit for Microsoft HoloLens. $3,000, and it comes with Young Conker as a launch game.
To an edge, he will play Vertigo animation.
Oh, heck!
Ew, no. No. Don't need Young Conker. I know it was rumored a little while back, like they dug through the titles on the Xbox store or whatever, but don't need this at all. Stay away. But it really just goes to show the price of these new devices and how much we really don't know. Of course, it's not a consumer price yet, but $3,000 for a dev kit seems steep. And finally, Pokemon Go cancels its GDC panel. I guess they said they wanted to focus more on the launch of the beta, but this was Niantic's chance to really show what the game actually looked like instead of that really spiffy teaser trailer for it. I don't know, missed opportunity. I think that's a mistake to miss out on this panel. We'll see the stories that come through next week. Bring it on, game industry.